Hey guys, welcome to the channel, and today I'm going to talk about my experience with Tesla after 5,000 driving 5,500 miles in last 5 months. I've been a proud owner from last 5 months. I can't even believe I was waiting for this car for almost 2.5 months, and now it's already 5 months. So I'm going to talk about how is the overall experience, my five top things which I absolutely love about Tesla, five things which I think, I can't say I hate, but could have been better, and overall feedback. So let's jump into it. So the first thing which I would like to talk about is the overall the look and the feel of the car. This is really one of the cars which is hetero. Like, if you go somewhere, you park your car, definitely people look at this car and they give you a compliment on the car. I can't even tell you how many people have asked me about this car, and that random people tell me that, hey, you got a really good looking car there. So that's one of the top features. I think it's designed in such a way, it looks very sporty, it's eye-catching, and then the overall interior, like once you start using the car, you realize that the minimalistic look which Tesla has gone, it grows over on you, and you start feeling that rest all cars have so much of clutter inside, unnecessary clutter which you don't even need it. It's personal preference, but then I think I like this better, the minimalistic look and the sporty looks. The second thing which I would like to talk about is the ease of use of this car, like from parking the car and you just don't have to worry about starting, stopping. You can just leave the car, get out of the car and walk away, and it locks for you. When you just come in and sit in the car, you don't have to worry about like starting it or doing something. Just sit, pull your gear and start driving. So really thought through process. It's an electric car, but then I also drove Mackie, and then there is a start and stop button there, which makes you think, why do you even need it? Like, why do you have to one more step to start the car? It's an electric car, it should know that you're sitting it, you're gonna drive it. So that's pretty amazing. And also the Sentry mode is one thing which has grown over me. It is amazing to have the security mode on when you park at unknown place, and when you come back you can actually see if somebody has came to your car, or sometimes you find that people are appreciating car, looking at it from all around. Sometimes you see that people are just like being careless parked in the normal parking lot. So it's amazing to have that backup. If you unfortunately meet up in an accident situation, or if somebody damages your car, you have the proof that what has happened. So Sentry mode is also amazing. That's the another thing which I love. The third thing which when I was buying this car, I heard a lot of people saying that the one pedal drive is not good, but then my personal feeling is it's an amazing thing. It grows over on you. The more you use it, that you feel like that it should be a part of every vehicle. I hardly use brakes nowadays, until somebody just drives in front of me from somewhere, and or somebody just brakes in front of me, and then only I use my brake. Otherwise I use the one pedal drive. It is such an amazing, it just takes a little while to get used to it, but once you are used to it, you have hard time going back. And whenever I drive my other car, which is an Acura, which is a great car, but after driving it for 5 months, if I drive that Acura occasionally, I have that feeling that, oh, I have to press the brake, and then my driving has become a little jerky in terms of when I try and drive the other car. So yeah, that's one pedal drive. You should try it. Once you will try it, I'm sure you're gonna love it. The fourth thing which I love, absolutely love about the car, is the autopilot, and autopilot feature. I don't have the FSD. I took the subscription for a month. I tried FSD. It was awesome, but I was not sold at this point on FSD, where most of the features are still under development, like parking, self-park. It works sometimes, it don't work sometimes. And then the summon feature, I think it's more of a party trick feature for me. But then lane assist, lane change was one of the amazing features. Also the red light stop and go feature was really, really good. I enjoyed both of them. But till the time the City Drive is available, I might not use, I might not buy full self-driving. So I think Autopilot is doing a decent job for me and I'm enjoying it. It keeps you centered in the lane and it takes off the stress of driving on long routes. I cannot even emphasize that how much good the Tesla's Autopilot is. It does a great job. I've driven to Chicago a couple of times, which is like a 4-hour drive from my place, and it just absolutely takes the pain of continuously driving in traffic or on long routes away. So hats off to Tesla for bringing that Autopilot service, which is really, really amazing. You should try it. The other thing which is pretty interesting in Tesla is the software updates. Your car stays up to date with the software updates. Tesla do a great job in bringing up new features to all the cars. So it's just like if you own a Pixel phone or an Apple phone, where whenever the new features come in, it is applicable to all the cars. So it's amazing. It's amazing, and they bring up some useful features, some party tricks all the time, and you look forward for the software upgrades. Just to give you an example, my Acura is like 4 years old now, and I got a message the other day from Acura that, hey, if you want to get your maps updated, schedule an appointment at dealer and it's going to cost you $150. And I was like, I bought a premium car. It should be a part and parcel of the car purchase experience, like maps update, navigation pack update. You're charging me an extra $150 for that? Makes no sense to me. So that's, I think Tesla has done a great job providing you new up-to-date features over the air updates, and one day you wake up and you see the software update and your car is now like brand new and totally changed. So that's pretty amazing. So these were the five points which I think I absolutely love about Tesla. Now let's talk about five points which I think could have been better. The first one is there is no dedicated blind spot monitoring, which I basically miss a lot. I know that the screen does all the job, you have the blind spot monitoring on the screen, but I would love it if it would have been on the mirrors outside, like I have it. I see it on other cars and I also have it on my Acura. It makes driving much more comfortable, because you know, like it's been 5 months now, and my natural instinct still, specifically if I'm looking to the left side, is not to look at the screen but look out in the mirror. It's kind of a double thing I have to do. I have to make sure I'm looking at the screen, that there's nothing on the left, and then I look out in the mirror, look in the rearview mirror. So it's kind of little distracting, and I have had situations where sometimes somebody was on my left side of blind spot and I didn't look at the screen, I just looked in the left, I was not able to see, and I was about to take a turn, and then the Tesla kind of pinged me that, hey, there is someone there. So it would have been good if they would have added, it's a premium car, it's at least priced at the premium segment, and they don't have the blind spot monitoring on the mirrors there. The second thing which I think could have been better is this rear view mirror. I think it is a little small. I keep adjusting it all the time. Most of the times either I am like looking at the back, the portion of the car which it meets the glass, or if I make it too up, I look at up. So it is not as big as it should be. So that's what my complaint is. This mirror could have been a little bigger, and it would have given me a better visibility. The other thing which I think I miss, like, is this car is priced at the premium car levels, like other premium cars. But then the overall feel, if you'll see, you can hear the road noise a lot. Sometimes you feel that the potholes and the suspension is not as great as all other German luxury cars. So that's one area which I think can be improved a little bit. The fourth thing which I think can be improved by some software update is the maps. The maps are great, the screen is amazing, you can see the like areas and everything. The only thing which I miss is that once you plan your route, you can't add a point in between your travel, like, you know, like on Google Maps or Waze, when you're driving from point A to point B and you want to add a Starbucks, you can just do a search and edit. This maps don't allow me to do that, and it's kind of sometimes get frustrating that why I can't do like a point of interest added while I'm going to that route. That should make the life a little bit more easier if they add that feature in that. And the last thing which I think it's on me, that I feel that the I'm in Indiana state and it's started getting a little cooler here. The window fogging, I can see the window fogging happening quite often on my front windshield, and then the air conditioning system is a little confusing. Like if you will see the system, there is a fan button, and then there is a temperature control, then there are the seat heating for the passenger side, and then there are two controls for the back mirror defogging in the front. So the back one is pretty obvious. You click it turns red and it starts heating up the mirror in the back. The front one, basically, which I think is a little confusing, when you tap it once it turns blue. And initially I was thinking that it's kind of sending the cold air up, that's the cool air. If you tap it again it turns red, and then it goes into high heating mode and it instantly start putting up the fan at the max speed and throws that hot air up, and your car gets really hot. So my observation is that the blue sign is not basically for sending a cooler. It's just the way Tesla presents that something is on or off. If you press it once, it turns blue. That means it's on. And whatever the AC and the temperature you have set, that's the air which is going on the windshield. So I compare it with my Acura. And I see that the less fogging happens on, and it's easy to control the fogging in the climate control in the Acura than this. I still have face issues in where my window is little bit, I can see a little bit of haze, and I have to play around to fix it. So yeah, these are the only issues which I think. Otherwise, overall, I am in absolutely love with this car. If my wife tells me let's go in Acura, I convince her to go in Tesla anywhere I want to go. In last 5 months, another thing which I want to talk is that I only had one service visit. That is also because I made a separate video, which I will put a link in description below if you want to see that, where my right repeater camera went going on flickering and turn out black, and then I some of the basic safety features turned off because of that. So I had to take an appointment and get that fixed. That experience was overall okay, because the time I book an appointment, I think Tesla service station was overbooked and there was some communication issues for which I had to let the car leave there for a day, and in my opinion the job was only for an hour or so, which the technician told me initially. Apart from that, it was a great experience. Everything, you can control it and see it from your mobile app. That's about it. And also I would like to suggest that if you have never used a app called OptiWatt, I use that app for my charging. It basically, download that app, you configure it, you connect it with your Tesla account, and you also put in information of your electricity provider and certain other information, and then it basically tells you that like how much electricity you have used cost wise to charge your a car, and also tells you that how much money you have saved in terms of driving that those many miles on charging, and saved how much in gas. It's pretty decent app. You can also do a kind of a scheduling on charging on that app, where you can charge it at certain times of the day, where if your electricity provider gives you that option when you have the electricity rates a little low, you can do that, and you can schedule it, and you can save money on that. So it's a great app. You can try it if you've never used it. You might end up saving some money by using that app. And the one last thing which I would like to talk about is how many people have reached out to me in my friend circle who know that I bought a Tesla. It's a common concern I see in people's mind that, hey, I know that there is no service, after service required in this car, but that what about the battery life? People have a lot of worries about the battery life in this car. So the battery life in this car is pretty decent. The warranty goes up to 120,000 miles or 8 years on on the battery, and then the basic warranty for the car is up to 50,000 miles on any parts, or like 4 years, whichever comes earlier. So I don't think so. There is much of the problem. There is a lot of misconception in people's mind that this is a very extremely expensive car, and it's not. Once you'll start using it, you will start loving it. That's about it. So let me know your thoughts, your if you have any comments, if anything you think is I have missed in this video. So let me know your thoughts and comments, and talk to you guys soon. Bye.